Radio.
See what happens.
Yeah. Sounds exciting.
See if we get going here. Still
don't
see our video.
Neither do I.
Oh, no idea. Wow, that was a long time ago. Hi, guys. I had to show the sexy picture I saw on Facebook today.
Yeah, I saw that picture too.
Yeah, look at that. Who's that? That's Daryl. That's for all the the walking fans. I can't even talk now because I'm looking at his picture. Yes,
I'm Norman Reedus.
The Walking Dead.
Walking, walking, walking.
Hey guys. I put the other picture up now. In case you're just walking in the room and you're looking at, you know, Daryl going, what is this? This is really mixing with Mandycat show. Look at all the people in the room. There's a lot of people in here, Bob.
Oh, I can't see how many there are.
You can't? Are you logged in?
Yeah, I'm logged in. Well, at least I was.
Yeah, we've got about 100.
You're very, yeah, I'm here. I'm logged in.
All right. So I'm going to get the intro rolling this time because I didn't get to play it last time because I was having tech issues. So let me cut the sexy music for Daryl for a minute and play the intro.
Okay.
Here we go.
Sam, my beard in the shot.
Skype, I don't know what that is. Hey guys, sorry about the choppy. I don't know what happened. I saw it stall on you guys too. Can you see me?
Could it be picking up the fan motor on my laptop?
It could be. It's like a reverbing, but it stops when we talk. So maybe if we just keep talking. And if you guys didn't know, this is Robert LEUR or Bob LEUR. Also, he's been in the room.
Yeah.
He's been in the room a few times. He's my special guest this afternoon. Yeah, hi, Bob. He's, you know what, he had headphones on, and that was worse. Hopefully, it doesn't interrupt us too much. So you guys get to know Bob. Go ahead, Bob, tell him a little bit about yourself, how long you've been vaping, where you're from.
Alrighty. I live in Beaver Dam, Wisconsin, a wonderful little community, north central or south central Wisconsin. I've been vaping since November of 2012, so it's about a year and 4 months now. year and 3 months. Mm-hmm. Hey, he used to smoke a carton a week for 38 years. Vaping helped me quit virtually the same week that I started. So that was good. Started off with, a nice little setup, little ego twist in the Vivi Nova.
Nice. The Vivis were big at one point. Some people still rock the Vivis.
Yeah. I still use it.
So what are you on now? What you vaping on now? What's your vape gear of choice?
Vape gear. Well, let's see. I've got my Kraken.
His Kraken. He's a rebuilder.
Yeah, almost all of my things, that's on a K100. Bring that a little closer. My
Those
video
Krakens
was...
are nice looking. I don't know if the video does it justice, but they are beautiful. Those Krakens are really beautiful.
Yeah, the engraving is really nice. Really
my
like that.
My audio seems low. Can you guys hear me okay? Can you hear us coming through okay? And Bob, you hear Bob okay?
Can anybody hear me?
I just got a message from somebody saying my audio is low. I didn't know if you guys could hear me. Make sure your volume's turned up too on your end. A little faint. Underneath the video, there's a volume control. I haven't changed nothing on my end. Yeah, that static is, I don't know where that static's coming from. It's something from the laptop, it has to be.
Yeah, it's got to be my fan motor on the laptop. It's been on all day. It's warm. It's blowing. My other two vapors of choice are my Z80 Pro on my Proberi and my Did Clone on my Bamo version 1 with the pink buttons. Yeah. I have two.
You have two Provaris too?
Yes.
I want a third one. I want a new one. I want the new hybrid colors.
I had to get one that was blue, and you can only see it's blue by looking at the bottom cap because I've got a jet wrap on it.
My husband just got a blue one in the mail today, and I don't think they make the blue ones anymore or the red ones. I think they're gone off the website.
New colors only?
The red and the solid blue are gone, so I don't know if they discontinued them because they brought in the hybrid.
Could be. Very possible. I have not gone back to their site recently, this month to look.
So this color red is no longer available, guys.
Wow, pretty. that. It looks like a battery.
It does. It looks like the AW battery.
No, it does.
Provari. I'm actually trying out the new tank on it. The Inokin 30B tank. It's dual foil. These are kind of nice.
Yeah,
I have to say it's better than the Pro Tank 3 dual foil. I do have to say that.
Yeah, my first i30s. Leaked. So I haven't used them much since then. Never bothered to figure out why or fuss with it.
I can't. That noise. I wish it would stop.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That noise.
You probably got ears like my wife.
It's I've got an earbud in, so it's right in my ear going. It's only when Bob talks.
So it's my microphone.
It's a microphone from the laptop, right?
I'm not sure what I'm set up on, actually.
No one is behind me tonight snoring, so you guys are safe. I was back there a few minutes ago. I almost didn't wake up for the show. It's been a long day. I just got out of the shower not too long ago. I got fluffy hair today, so... I'm wearing my pajama bottoms and a comfy shirt because I haven't felt that great either. So, So you get to see Lounge and Mandy tonight. Sounds okay. Like elf farts. I've never heard an elf fart before, but that's interesting. Elf says, I never fart. So, okay. What are we going to be doing today, Bob? What are you going to do for the audience?
I thought we would start off with one of the first liquids I ever DIY'd, and that is Jamaican 10-speed, which if you're in the DIY Facebook group that Mandy has, it's in the files. And it is probably strange because they recommend running this at about 35% flavor, which is unusual from what I've heard from or read from other people. So it starts out, the simple recipe is two parts of watermelon.
Go ahead and start saying that again.
Okay. Two parts of TPA watermelon, TFA, comes out to 11.5% if you need the percentage.
Guys, make sure you have your handy dandy notepads out.
Yeah. Two parts of TFA Bavarian cream, which is also 11.5%.
Okay.
TFA banana, one part, which is actually in this case 6%. So it didn't translate well to the parts. And one part of TFA coconut extra, which is what I use, and that's also 6%.
Yum.
Basically, you just mix all the flavors together and then add your PG, your VG, and your Nick. I use a PG base, Nick.
Nice. And now, can I ask you why you chose PG Nick base for yourself?
I chose it because I had read that PG was a better flavor carrier.
Okay.
And I knew that if I wanted to have a high VG or a medium VG, that it should help balance.
Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. You're going to hear a little static here and there. There's something going on with the Skype call between us. It's kind of got some interference. So bear with it. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
So this is called again. Go ahead and say the name of your recipe because it's in the Facebook group.
Yes, Jamaican 10-speed.
Nice. So when you vape it, what are the high notes of your flavor when you actually vape the flavor? What is prominent?
The watermelon and coconut to me.
So watermelon, coconut, we've got banana in there. Sounds yeah. Like a very interesting recipe. And we're going to watch him make it too.
Yeah. It's kind of crazy because I started DIY because I don't taste a lot of the things that other people taste. You know, they describe all these wonderful high notes and low notes, and I'm an old man, and my taste buds are shot.
You know, I actually had a taste bud problem today. I got low on my Mandy's melons, but I was tired of it, so I made myself some raspberry lemonade, and I made myself some Dole Whip. Yesterday, I vaped Dole Whip. Today I was on raspberry lemonade, and halfway through the day, I'm like, I want something else. So at the last minute, I decided maybe 2 hours ago to make a new flavor, and I threw together some banana, some lemonade, some cream, whipped cream, and sweet cream, because I wanted the banana taste, but I also wanted a sour, tangy taste, so I made a banana lemonade pudding.
Ooh.
Maybe it's because I'm pregnant and that sounded good, but it actually turned out really good. I'm vaping it right now.
That sounds good. I like that.
they're like, whoa. Actually, it's funny because the lemonade gives the banana this weird tangy taste, but it's still creamy. I can't even explain it, but it tastes pretty good to me.
Okay. I'll put my gloves on when I get to my Nick.
Okay.
Until then, I'm just going to use my fingers.
I'm going to zoom you in, too, so they can see you. So if you guys...
Ten speed. And the back... Yeah, the background on that name, from what I have read, is that it's actually a tropical drink served in Jamaica and their malts. So someone came up with this wonderful recipe, and I'm just going to copy it. Really? Oh, I got it. All right. So we're starting out with my 11.5% of watermelon. Yes. Let me bring that in. I buy a little bit of that. That's correct. I normally use and I put a link in our chat. I use the calculator, eJuice calculator V13. Yeah. Right. And it does not give you the number of parts or the percentage. I had to do the math myself. I just know that now that is the standard. This calculator runs, it's an Excel spreadsheet. It comes with about 70 pre-made, pre-loaded recipes. A lot of flavors in there, a lot of different things. It does a lot of multi-functions. It'll calculate your costs for, your liquid. It'll track all that stuff if you want it to. Mm-hmm. But I don't.
I don't know why my sound didn't come in for a second there. I know, because I had my mic on mute. Sorry about that. So they only heard you talk, and they didn't hear me asking the question.
Oh, okay. Next thing is my Bavarian cream.
TPA.
TPA. And again, you could tell I've used a little bit of this. Mm-hmm. I just took my, wanted to take my cap off, and turning it the wrong way, I think. That one,
you notice, this one's just... Bob uses different needles and syringes, just like we do for our flavoring. He also has, I think that's a paper towel laid out to collect any spillage.
Yes.
Which is smart. I use a towel. He's using a paper towel, which is nice. You just throw it away when you're done. Hey, man.
Yeah. So we'll add that. These are large gauge, I think. I don't know what gauge they are. I don't remember.
They look like they're red. They look like 18 gauge blunts.
Yes, they were supposed to be blunts. They are not.
They're sharp.
They're sharp. Which I found out the hard way the first time I tried to take a cap off. So there's, again, 3.5 milliliters. And we'll do 1.8. I'll put that away.
Now notice, guys, he's adding his flavor into the bottle before anything else.
Yeah. You can see there, coconut extra. The original recipe called for straight coconut. I don't have any. So I improvised and used coconut extra. For me, it works. I like the flavors. Now, this is one 1.8 milliliters. Okay, I gotta take that up.
And then I am snips the tips off his 18 gauge needles. Ooh, yeah, be careful doing that.
I thought of doing that, and I'm concerned that I'm going to close up that opening.
You could pinch it. You could also get some metal shavings. So I would be cautious doing that. And also, if you're using sharp needles, be careful so you don't stick yourself.
Right. And now another deviation from my normal recipe.
Uh-huh.
I have ripe banana.
Okay.
And when I make it for myself, I use ripe banana. But since I'm going to give this away, I'm going to use banana cream so I don't crack anybody's tank.
Okay, that's a good point. If you guys didn't know, ripe banana is very strong. If you ever use ripe banana, you don't need to use a lot of it. And it can crack tanks, definitely. Banana cream is a nice smooth banana, too.
Yeah, the ripe banana, I probably won't use it again, but that's what I bought. So I've been using it. And it did. It cracked one of my tanks. I think I may have brought that tank to one of the meets and showed people.
I did that once. I put it in a Vivi tank, and I literally loaded the tank up, and within seconds, I sat there and watched fracture cracks just start appearing all over the tank until it crumbled into a bunch of little pieces from ripe banana. I was like, holy cow.
Yeah, it's really shocked me, because I know what I had. My very first Aga tea, the one before, it's the very first one. It's got the knurling on it.
All right, guys, notice he mixed all his flavors together before he's done anything else. So he's added every flavor into the bottle, and then you saw him shake it.
Yep, I'm going to shake it a little. Shake, 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 shake.
See how he's mixing the flavors first?
That's good. I mean, you don't... Cool. Smells good. Then I'm going to add my
tea. You guys probably hear my dog in the background. The chicken guy's here.
PG is 2.4 milliliters, and I've got a very nice...
nice lip tip.
Yeah. I got mine free at Walgreens.
Walgreens, cool.
I talked to the pharmacist. I brought in one of my tanks, and I showed him what I needed it for and asked if they sold it, and they said, no, we don't sell it, but I can give you a couple.
Very nice. And yes, I have a chicken guy. He brings me chicken, Regal potatoes, coleslaw, and French bread.
So regular PG, and this is going to be 12 milligram when we end up with everything.
Cool. So he's making you guys a 12 milligram juice here.
Yeah, I'm not sure if you see it. I fill it up a little on this one, and then I squirt it back into the bottle to get the air bubble out, because this has a flat bottom. So I can draw up to 2.4. I can read. And then shush that in, and that was my plain PG element.
All right, that's the PG's been added.
Yeah.
And this is Jamaican 10 Speed. That's the name of the flavor. You can find it in the DIY Facebook group. And I'm going to throw that link in again.
Yep. Then I've got my VG. Now, I use this bottle because it's convenient. It's convenient size.
Is that really Humco VG, or are you using some kind of other VG?
I'm using something else.
Space Invaders.
What?
Somebody said, I think they said it sounded like Space Invaders.
Oh, yep. it got wet.
Essential Depot. So he puts Essential Depot in that little bottle there because it's a smaller size. Like he buys a gallon. He's a real DIYer.
Yeah. I bought the gallon because they were, I think it was $20 for a gallon of each.
Uh-huh.
At Essential Depot, plus you got free shipping.
Nice.
So this is 13.5 milliliters. So that was 10. And I'm covering up, you know, so you can't see it. But that's because, you know, it's not a real interesting picture. I gotta go 13.
They're saying they're only finding Jamaican vanilla tobacco on the DIY grill, but we might have to re-add it. Is that it?
No, it's in one of the very early posts under drink recipes.
Oh, it's under drink recipes.
Or something to that effect. Well, I didn't get my nipple in the bottle, and I overfilled it.
And sometimes that happens if you get an air bubble in there. It comes out on the side of your bottle. I've seen that happen.
Yeah. Which normally my long tip doesn't do that, but...
Yeah, usually slip tips are good with that.
Yeah. I suppose if I used a more conventional method that would...
Sister, I hate when my nipple doesn't fit in the bottle.
Oh, I do. And now my Nick.
Hey, vaping addict. Nice. Is that from Wizard Lab?
Yeah.
Okay, your Nick's from Wizard Lab.
Yeah, this is 100 milligrams, so the gloves will come out. Which I'm really good at putting on, you know.
Thank you, Dakota Jim. He found it.
Okay. Yeah, because it wasn't listed by itself there. But there are a lot of good recipes buried in there. You know, which is a good point for people who use that site to be diligent and look.
His VG is not from Wally World. He puts Essential Depot VG in the bottle because it's a smaller bottle. So he reuses the bottle.
I do it yourself because it's cheap.
The first time I bought VG, I got it at Walmart, and I had a Humco bottle, and I did not. It made my DIY taste like crap.
Well, I recycled enough of that out to not have any bad parts. Now here I need like 3.6. Yeah, a little tiny ear bubble, and I hate doing this.
If you've tried VG from Walmart, and then you've tried like Essential Depot VG, and you make the same recipe, I'm telling you, you're gonna taste the difference. Use the same recipe with two different VGs, you'll taste the difference.
Yeah. Well, again, you guys will.
Nice, Texas girl. I still haven't ordered the new cherry from One Stop. I forgot to do that.
Yeah. Now, I don't know if you see it, but I am putting all my needles back into a bottle of water.
Nice. Ready to go wash them up when you're done.
Yeah. Now, I hear a lot of people wash with hot water, and I never do.
What do you do?
I always wash with cold water.
With cold water?
I rinse the heck out of them. I've got good tap water here.
Good website for flavoring. You can get all your stuff at One Stop DIY, which is a sponsor of this show, and we'll be doing a giveaway later from One Stop after we do our mixing. There's One Stop link.
We'll mixing.
If you're new and not sure what you want to get, that's the one-stop place you want to go. A lot of DIYers move up to shopping at Flavor West if they like them. They go to Capella's if they like Capella's. They also, some people get flavoring from Wizard Labs. Some people get flavoring from, you can get it from Heartland now, which is another sponsor.
Okay. Am I on? I'm not on the main screen. Okay. I'm going to try this.
He's moving his camera.
Let's see if I can get a good picture.
Look at all the flavoring. Woo!
Yeah, you'd think I wouldn't need to do this, but you'll see Wizard Labs. You'll see.
Use a wide variety. Yep, look at that.
Yeah. Well, I pared this down. I pared my collection down from things that I use more often.
Uh-huh.
And it's interesting.
I've seen KB, she said, wait till you see my flavorings. I've seen her post her bottles in the DIY Facebook group. She gets the huge ones and a lot of them.
I haven't tried to take a good picture yet. I just got a better webcam, so I'll be able to do that more. So should I go right into mixing the other one?
Sure.
Okay.
What are we making next?
Well,
what are you making next?
I am making something called Perfect Watermelon. And right now, now the Jamaican 10 speed, when I started vaping, it was a strong flavor. And that was my all day vape. And now I've gone to a watermelon, which is more than just watermelon. We've got, we'll line this up. Going to have watermelon. Yeah. Going to use our watermelon again.
TPA watermelon. Okay.
Yeah. Percentage wise, it comes out at 20.46.
Okay.
If you use percentages, this is honeydew.
And that's TPA as well.
Yeah, TFA.
TFA, honeydew. Yum.
Might even read it. That comes in at 3.3% with 3.3% of the cantaloupe. And I'm sorry, I'm holding that crooked. And orange cream.
Nice.
3.3%.
Now, would you say the cantaloupe to the audience, do you find it strong from TPA?
I don't.
You don't find it strong?
I don't know that I have bought it from other places to compare it. It just, I don't vape it straight, so I pretty much use it only in this mix.
Right. All right. So what's this called? Just the Perfect Watermelon, right?
A Perfect Melon might be a better name. I call it Perfect Watermelon. So we're going to start with the watermelon.
And again, he puts his flavors in the bottle first before he puts anything else.
Yes. And now I don't know. Only drawback is I didn't really clean my needles out. Flavor needles, and I didn't mark which one I used watermelon on. That could be a problem.
D-Millen's holding off on buying flavors because one flavor is out of stock. Well, get the other flavors while they're in stock. No, just kidding. What flavor are you waiting for, D-Millen?
Mixing. I'm drawing up. I need 6.14 milliliters, so it's going to be two tubes.
And those are TB syringes, correct? I didn't say that at the beginning. They look like TB syringes.
BD.
Yep, BD. They're locked TB 1cc syringes.
These are three. Milliliter. They just look smaller.
One Stop doesn't have any websites that have maple flavor. One Stop doesn't have maple flavor? I thought they did. I have a TPA maple flavor. I love BD brand. That is my favorite brand for my TB syringes. I do use Terumo 10cc's slip tip.
Wow. Say that best 10 times.
Terumo.
Okay, so we'll put the honeydew in next. Again, TFA honeydew. We only need, what I like about this is we only need 1 milliliter.
Honeydew is a nice sweet flavor too. I like the honeydew.
I like them all.
And thank you guys for providing links in the chat for me. You guys are awesome. Viewers rock.
I think what surprised me is mixing all three of these together really provided a depth of flavor that you couldn't get with just one. Mm-hmm. Antelope is next. It'll also be one.
Have you ever tried melons from Lorand's?
Me? No, I don't think I have. I have some Lorand's flavorings. I just don't believe I have that one.
If you ever get a chance, try melons from Lorand's.
Yeah.
If you like melon kind of stuff. Don't use it alone. Add some other stuff with it, but it's good.
Yeah. 1 milliliter there. Cantaloupe.
Thank you, Pammy. I thought they had maple there. I also have is it maple syrup? I think it's maple syrup. Lorand's apple flavoring's not bad either. maple and maple syrup. Sweet. I thought they had it.
And you know, maybe
the best part about Lorand's is you don't need a lot of it.
Again, a lot of people say things like that, but I personally just could not taste the difference.
I have sensitive taste buds, especially now that I'm pregnant.
Oh.
I mean, I'm basing bananas and lemonade right now, so.
Okay. So the other little things that I do that I didn't mention are I use three drops of colada. And you can see that is from TFA.
Awesome. And you know what? Somebody put in there, some of Lorand's flavorings are not vape safe. And SoCal is absolutely right. You need to read the description of those flavors. Some of those have oil in them. So make sure you don't buy the ones with oil.
So this is the only time I really use one of these little tiny pipettes.
Oh, look at that little baby pipette. Look at that thing. I've never seen that one.
Oh, yeah?
It's the mini pipette.
It is. I probably got that at Wizard Labs.
Look how cute. It's so adorable. I want one just to have one and go, look at my little pipette.
Wow.
Yeah, never use oil flavors in your vape juice. There was a company that was selling some with oil base in it. Who was that? Vapor Renew might have had some oil. I think I got a tea from Vapor Renew that it separated, and I'm like, oh, I didn't know they were selling that with oil in it.
Okay, now I'm using Tart and Sour, which is again flavor PFA.
Lowrance.
No, this is Lowrance. I'm sorry.
That's Lowrance. Yep. That's great for that. Just, you only need a little bit of it too for that sour.
Right. And I'm putting 3 drops because I'm doing a 30 mil bottle. Otherwise, I do 1 drop per 10 milliliter.
Might have to get SoCal on here one day too.
And I'm going to use marshmallow as a sweetener.
You're going to fluff it.
Yeah.
He's making it fluffier and sweeter.
And I don't have a real accurate measurement. It's half of that dripper.
Okay. Yeah, if your juice is separating, there's a big chance that there's oil in something. Because oil and water don't mix. So they separate.
Yes. So,
Albie, right now this is Bob Lohr, who is on with us. What's your Vaughn name? Your screen
Robert
name?
Robert Lohr.
What is it?
Skype name?
No, for Vaughn.
Robert Lohr.
Robert Lohr. You'll see him as Robert Lohr.
Yeah, you know, I'm very imaginative, aren't I?
Oh, Canyon Vapor's here. Yay, another sponsor walked in the room.
There we go. Just typed in the room. Okay, so we're going to add 3.6 milliliters of propylene glycol, PG.
This is great. I've been busy all day working, so it's really nice to sit back and watch somebody else mix. I really enjoy this part of the show.
Oh, you should. You should, because you work hard.
I do enough mixing.
Yeah.
What was the total percentage on this recipe that you said at the beginning?
I'm actually mixing it to my flavor taste at 31%.
31% is his flavor taste. If that's too high for someone, of course you could tweak it down some.
Yeah. But the other thing is that it made the 3 flavors come in at just 1 milliliter each.
What is the average cost of the flavors he's using? Now, he's got the 4-ounce big bottles there. That marshmallow was a 4-ounce TBA bottle.
Right.
What did you pay for that?
$6 or $8.
$6 or $8 for 4 ounces. That's pretty good. And then the little bottles, you probably paid around $3 or so for.
Well, a bottle this size was like $1, like $1.50. And then yeah, these here are probably about these might be $4.
Yeah,
and these
that sounds
one
about right.
Probably $8.
That sounds about right.
Yeah.
Yes, so call. See, I'm going to have you on the show so you can mix and I can sit here and just chat with you.
Yeah. You know, there's prices are relative. It a lot depends, I found, on where you're buying your juice. Everybody's got different pricing,
right.
At least on the hobbyist level.
I can't tell you what I pay for pricing. It's different.
Right. Yeah, I know. You get that wholesaler.
They wouldn't yell at me for missing chat. See, I would follow the chat for you.
I'm adding this very slowly because I don't want to flood my bottle. And I'm looking for, again, 13.5. The only thing is these big syringes are not good for real accurate.
That's why I like the bubble technique.
Yeah. Well, what I find is, well, for myself, I can take my glasses off and I can hold it right up in front of my face so I can see it.
Yeah.
But obviously, I can't do that on the show here.
Scoop's like, your nose is a bubble. All right, so he's putting those gloves back on because he's going to handle 100 milligram Nick.
Yeah. Which, you know, I created a shortage because I bought both of these at once.
Add your own flavoring into a premixed bottle of PG and BG. Well, if it's just PG and BG, of course you can.
You could premix it. Absolutely.
Dakota Jim, my nose is long enough to slide my glasses down to look over the top.
Wow. That's very impressive.
Hey, Celtic. Welcome to the room. And we are going to be taking calls in the later half of the show, so I will spot that phone number up. So get your phone numbers ready, your phone ready to call in. You can talk to Bob. You can talk to me. I don't bite. There's an easy day with kids? Where's that technique at?
Alrighty. I'll cap that.
Ah, my brother. If you want me to bite, I will bite. If that's your preference. Yes, yeah, some vendors do sell premixed. Off the top of my head, EC something comes to mind. Who is that? I can't think of who it is.
EC Blends? I don't know, it's the only EC I can think of.
Maybe? Oh, My Freedom Smoke does? Okay.
Oh, yeah. I've got flavoring from My Freedom Smoke and from DIY Flavor Shack, Loran's, Vaping Zone.
Nice.
I went out and I bought a lot of small bottles.
Which is great to do if you want to try a flavor. Don't go right away and buy a huge bottle if you're just going to try it.
So you can see the Jamaican 10 speed. I think my...
A little bit darker. I mean,
yeah, it looks darker. That's the Bavarian cream.
I was just going to say, that's the Bavarian cream is a darker yellow kind of tint. And your melons there are pretty clear. All those flavors are clear. It will turn as it steeps a little bit, but not too much with the melons.
You know, maybe 24 hours of steeping on that for me. Mm-hmm. I don't find that I need a lot.
I'm a fan of Bavarian cream. I know, I don't think Jeannie K likes it as much. I'm a fan of an accent Bavarian cream when I'm making a pudding or any kind of creamy kind of flavor. I like the Bavarian cream. Don't overdo the Bavarian cream. Okay, Bob's getting back on the screen now so you can see him.
Yeah, like they want to.
Someone asked earlier, are we mixing with Heisenberg because they saw your shirt?
Oh, no. Not at all. But yes, my shirt. I saw this shirt. Posted somewhere, and I had to buy it. It's awesome.
Who's selling that shirt? I like that shirt.
Somebody out in California. Oh, I don't remember off the top of my head. I'm sure I save emails on everything. So
nice.
I'm sure I could dig it up. But I don't know.
Slick Nick is vaping a DIY disaster. What are you vaping? What flavors? Oh. What's so disastrous about your vape?
But I will say that I notice a fairly good difference between devices on my juice.
How so? Like the power?
Yeah, the flavor. I mean, when you mix your own, you can really tell the difference when you go, you know, from something like this that has, where am I?
You know, that has that tank on there. That's a sexy tank.
Yeah.
Where'd you get that tank at?
Oh, I just picked it up on the internet, you know.
Look at that pretty tank.
Some timeless camper place. Something like that that's got a silica wick to a Jenny, to something else where, you know, some of my EVODs, and this little thing.
Yes, the little arrow tank on an ego. Yeah. You know what? I'm thinking about my next show. I don't like my VTR because it does change the flavor than a Pivari. There's a lot of power in this VTR. It's completely different from the power, even if I set it at the same voltage as my Pivari. I just don't use it, and I used it maybe the day I got it, and maybe another day after that. And I'm thinking about giving it away to you guys if you want it. It's a pretty much brand new VTR. You'll get the box with it. You'll get the adapter. You won't get my used aero tank, though. So maybe I'll do that next week. What do you think? Should I give away my VTR? I'm not using it, so maybe someone else will.
Yeah, that reminds me of something I've got. I've got a T-Max.
I gave my T-Max away, too.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if I can really give it away anymore because the connector broke off and I had to wedge it back in.
Yeah, you know, it's heavy to me, too, so I don't.
Yes.
And I don't have a 134 either, but I'm going to give away the VTR. You have to wait. Hold on. I have to take me off screen for a minute. Let me put you up so I can give my son a hug and kiss.
Yes. Okay. Yeah.
There we go.
So while that's all going on,
go brush your teeth.
Just want to say that I started DIY because while I liked a couple of the juices that I bought, and I tried to judge by online reviews and stuff, I just found that I wasn't getting the flavors that I thought I should. So I started buying little kits, mixing stuff up, and
well, you sound like you like 30% or more in your flavoring.
Yeah.
A lot of vendors either do 15% to 20%. Not many do 30% in their flavors. So if flavor.
I mean, I can see why. I mean, you know, I totally get it, but it's what works for me.
I don't think I rarely go over 20%, maybe 22 here and there. I gave my T-Max away already, but I am going to give I think I will give my VTR away next week. I'll put it in the box. I'll shine it up. Like I said, it's had maybe 2 days use on it, and then it just sits there, and every day I have to dust it off. Might as well give it to somebody who can use it.
Yeah, I can feel that. I can certainly agree with that. So we can take calls, we can take questions.
All right, let me go ahead and throw the number up. Blah. I'm just kidding, hold on. I mean, I know I wrote it down here. So I can just throw it on the screen. Let's see. Nope, that's not it. It's in my top banners.
Okay.
There it is. Yay. While we do that, I'm going to go ahead. There's the call-in for you guys. Feel free to call in. Gonna talk about some of my sponsors real quick here. So we're gonna give away the two juices that Bob made today, and we're also gonna give away one bottle from Canyon Vapor. And what I want you guys to do, hold on, I know I have it here. Canyon Vapor, Facebook. I want you guys. Hey, Canyon Vapor, you still in the room? You have your Facebook page? I want people to go put likes on your page. So throw that in the chat. Skype went down. Did Skype go down?
No, I'm just sitting still again. You know, I forget this action show sort of stuff. Oh.
Yep, I should. We lost video? Did I? No. I'm still up.
All right. I still see you. Okay. I mean, on the website. On Nova.
Huh. I see video good. Okay, working here.
Okay, Shanti, what happened is several months ago, I crashed one of Mandy's vape meets for her club.
Yes.
And that's what I'm talking about.
What ratio should you use for just VG and flavoring? If you're using 100% VG, or, you know, except for the flavoring, you're going to want to go higher, at least 20 or more in percentage, because VG is going to eat that flavoring. Ghostberry is the nom noms. Yes, I had the Ghostberry from Canyon Vapor. If you guys are getting the juice from them, I would definitely suggest it's from Steam Junk, I believe, on his website. Also, he's got some flavors by Joe up there as well. Hey, John. Welcome to the room. Mandy, ask Bob what vape meet he was talking about going to, please. What vape meet are you going to, Bob?
Well, I might be, provided we don't get a massive ice storm, I might be attending the Northwest Indiana Vapors Club vape meet on February 1st.
Oh, would that be the Steel City Vapors Club?
Yes, yes. that would be another name for them.
Yay! We love when Bob visits us. If you can't make it, I understand. The weather's been horrendous this winter.
hey, it's our predictions for Saturday are 24 degrees, so I'm hopeful. Of course, that probably means
a heat wave.
probably means a snowstorm.
Oh God! No more snow.
But I've also gone to several vape meets at our local club, which is Wisconsin Vapors.
Look at that nice mug! You guys got mugs?
I had to buy this. I'm a mug collector.
How cool! It sounds like a Pittsburgh club. Well, the Steel City Vapors Club was named after the fact that we have steel mills right down the street. My husband actually works at Inland Steel. So we have steel mills just like Pennsylvania. And so we called it the Steel City, not realizing there's a Pittsburgh or a PA group for that too. So we're the Northwest Indiana ones.
Yeah.
Let's see. No callers yet, as of yet. I'm also going to throw the fact that One Stop DIY is a proud sponsor of this show, and we'll be giving away a $25 gift certificate to shop at One Stop as well. Yay! We're in Indiana. I live in the Hammond area. I call it the armpit of Indiana, up by the lake and up in the corner. Close, you know, it's not far to go to Chicago.
Yeah, I just saw that they closed down I-94 for the entire state of Indiana.
That was actually last week, and I posted it late.
Oh, okay.
Let's see, Mandy, for those of us using PG with a PG sensitivity and can't do more than 20% PG, the chat keeps moving. What do you suggest? Are the vendors that deals in VG flavorings? There is a list in the DIY Facebook group, I believe, that shares the VG flavoring. Are you in the Facebook group? Are you on Facebook? The DIY Facebook group? Rich made it to the Steel City Vapors Club. Yes, he did, and he had some of my tortellini salad for the 1 year anniversary.
Yeah.
Yeah, there should be a list in there for the places that carry the VG flavoring. There's not a lot of options, but there are some. Ghost Riders from Northwest Indiana, or Indiana. Cool.
You know, the few tips that I have is that I'm able to wash all my syringes in just straight cold water. For me, again, maybe because I'm not that sensitive to flavor, I'm not able to detect any cross-contamination. I save everything. I'm cheap.
Cool.
I reuse for my own personal use just about every bottle I get. But I'm not doing that. I would give these away if anybody would be interested in them.
What sweetener works best for fruit flavors? Now, everybody's probably going to have a different opinion on that. If you don't want to clog your coils up too much, I use cotton candy. Some people use sucralose. Some people use ethyl maltol crystals and dissolve them in PG themselves. What do you use? And stevia. What do you use, Bob?
I'm using either marshmallow or yep. I've gotten away from it again because it clogs everything that it touches.
Uh-huh.
But I have used liquid stevia.
See, some people use the stevia. I've never used the stevia myself personally. I'm good with the cotton candy pre-made. Also, while I'm at it, you guys, go give some likes to the DIY Facebook group. This is one-stop DIY group. Oh, that's a DIY group link. Where did I put the... I had it here. I lost it. DIY has a Facebook group, too. She needs some likes. I can't find it now. Do you recommend testing your new bottles of nick base for accurate nick percentages when you get them? I get my nick from Heartland, and Heartland has already tested it, and they send the paperwork with it.
Nice.
Some websites post it on their website. You can buy a nick testing kit at Wizard Labs, I believe, has them for a very reasonable price. Thank you, PME.
Oh, did you see the Phil Bisardo's review on doing the nick testing? It was hilarious.
No, I didn't see his.
Yeah, he pretty well said that, unless you have to do it, it's a lot of work.
Yeah, and if you're not very keen on lab stuff, it might look foreign to you, but they do have the kits at Wizard Lab.
Yeah.
To test.
Yeah, he was doing, he had a kit where you had to add a certain number of drops until the color mixed and matched some
test. I'll have to look up that review from him. I can only imagine.
And yeah, Phil was just like, holy moly.
What am I doing? You like the review of the noodle from today. Be careful on the nicotine test kit too from EBA. Is that one in the States? Because there's another one that sells an anti-titration kit on eBay, but it's being shipped from like Australia or somewhere, and you can end up paying $50 in shipping. So make sure you read where it's coming from.
No, I don't believe Phil DIYs. I think he gets enough juice.
From nude nicotine. Okay. That's a new place. I haven't even heard of that place. Nude nicotine. What's the link to that? Okay, they are in the States. So that's good. I'm weary of eBay buying. I don't know. I got scammed on there one time. And that makes me very leery that I don't spend so much money on eBay because of that. Vape tweak gears came with a lab report. That's good. Yeah, you got to really check that stuff out on eBay. The sellers, their stars, their remarks. And I did. The person that I got scammed on, I think it was for a baby item or something I was getting for the crib a couple years ago, or back when my son was born. That was longer than a couple years ago. But anyway, I got scammed on it. I was mad. I know, but it teaches you something that, you know, I won't spend a certain amount of money on eBay. I'll just go buy it somewhere else from a reputable source. I don't want to be rude, but when the giveaway is starting, it's like 4 a.m. here. Where are you from, vaping addict? That it's 4 a.m.
Wow.
That makes me even more leery of eBay reading your comment, Bronny. The yellow and the nick could be urine on eBay. That makes me feel so wonderful.
Ooh. That's just bad.
We are going to get to the giveaways. We still have an hour left of the show. Don't want to rush through all that.
Yeah, I think I got my ultrasonic cleaner from eBay, but I'm not sure. Might have been Amazon.
Which ultrasonic cleaner do you have?
Well, let me go look at it because I don't remember.
Now, I do want to say there's something special going on in the Facebook DIY group. We're approaching in that group close to 5,000 members. And when that happens, there's going to be an awesome giveaway of all kinds of sorts. There's probably a huge list of giveaways going right now. I've added to the list of giveaways with stuff that I purchased for a DIY starter kit that I used. I took the funds for those of you who don't DIY and bought Fluffy Bitch, who bought Nova's Bounty. I took those funds and, you know, put it into a nice DIY kit with flasks, glass beakers, Nick, PGVG bottles, flavoring, and I'm putting it together for you guys.
Okay, this is the SPT model, UC609. Ultrasonic cleaner with digital.
It's got a from eBay?
9-minute timer. Yeah, a nice little removable basket.
Cool.
It only does 9 minutes at a time. Then you just have to walk over and press the button again. It shoots up in 1-minute increments.
Very nice.
I used to use it, and now, you know, with these two flavors, most flavors I mix these days do not require any steeping, in my opinion.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Here's a preferred U.S. Amazon. Thank you for that link, Dakota Jim. I use a Dremel vibrating sander to mix. I saw somebody do that. I don't know how they did that, but I seen that.
I would imagine it would scare the dog. Our cats don't care.
Hello, dirty little bitch. Welcome to the room.
Yeah.
All right, vaping addict. Have a good night. You must be across the pond.
Must be.
It's only 8 o'clock here. So that's really early where he is. Okay, great, guys. And the other thing about the Facebook group is you might have to contact an admin if your Facebook page doesn't show that you have any vaping friends and stuff. They're very cautious about who comes in the group to eliminate spammers and sellers from China and stuff like that. So if you don't get added right away, contact one of the admins. I am one of the admins as well. So you can PM me and I'll get you in the group. But you have to be in the group when the giveaways happen. Like I said, we're approaching 5,000 and there's going to be a slew of giveaways over there. They denied you 10 times. Oh, jeez.
What, wasn't it like 4980 today?
It's getting up there. Oh, let me put you back on the screen. My daughter wants to kiss goodnight.
Oh, okay, great.
Hold on, let me switch my screen. I can't have you get on the TV. Oh, I can't find you now.
I'm lost. Help.
Oh, there you are. Okay, there you go.
Shoot a flare. Well, there's quite a bit of a delay here, okay. Because from what I'm seeing, there. Oh.
Yeah, wow. There is a huge delay.
Hi there.
He's like, hi there. Large and in charge. Bob is large and in charge.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Some people well, are Sean, like, I'm not on there.
I've converted 3, and I'm sure there are others in different different age groups and different social circles.
They love your beard.
Thank you. You know, it's kind of standard equipment. If you don't cut it off, it just shows up.
You kind of look like Heisenberg there with the beard going when you took off.
No, I don't bite much.
If you had the hat, you would be Heisenberg.
I don't know.
Hey, Jamie, how you doing, sweetie? What? There was a kiosk guy who sold an 11-year-old?
What kind of hat? God.
He's got that like fedora looking hat that he wears. He got a fedora looking hat. I'm gonna get Heisenberg on here.
Okay.
Now you look like you're from the Old West. You could be Pleiades's lookalike.
Wow. Okay, well, if it ain't that hat, probably isn't this one.
Duck Dynasty.
I've had this hat for years, by the way. I can show you the dust that's accumulated on it.
Wailing Jennings.
Here we go.
He's got a look at all his hats.
Yeah, I have these because I used to shoot some videos for video gaming, and I always wanted a different look in each one of them.
Nice.
But hats make my head all sweaty and yuck.
Dakota Jim, what state do you live in? I thought most states had already pushed the you have to be 18 or older to buy e-cigs. Is your state not done that yet?
What a top hat.
Video games, that's what you're talking about.
Yeah, my Xbox 360.
Here, South Dakota. Dakota got Jim.
My monitor over there.
Zero. Yeah, but I thought it was anything used for an e-cig. So they just say if it's zero nick, they can sell you a battery and device. But why would you want to give that to an 11-year-old? Really?
Yeah, really. Why start a mutton?
Somebody asked, what do you play, Bob?
Right now, I just play Skyrim. Played a lot of Mass Effect. I played a lot of Ghost Recon in the first Xbox. Oh, Gears of War. Ooh, played a bunch of them.
Nice. Well, that's good that they most of them are self-regulated. But those kiosks, I would turn them in. Can't you turn them in to authorities for that crap? Have that the parents of that 11-year-old come kick the kiosk owner's ass.
Yeah, they should. Uh-huh. You know, and you know, call me old fashioned, but what are you letting your 11-year-old run around the mall for without supervision?
It's amazing what goes on in today's world. So, you know what, mm-hmm. I sent my letters about the California, where was it, San something, they were banning e-cigs. Anyone know what turned out today? I thought they were having a meeting today. I've been so busy, I haven't been able to follow it. It just came up in the last minute. Anyone know what happened with that?
I'm reading the chat.
Can they really ban e-cigs when most states are regulating it? That's just odd. And Vermont was doing the same thing.
California is very, very conservative on some of those things.
Yeah, what happened with Vermont? I haven't heard anything else about that either. Vermont was trying to ban e-cigs completely, that you would be fined if you were caught with an electronic cigarette.
Oh, very hot.
Oh, they wanted to cut the online taxes. Okay. I've been so busy, and this stuff pops up sometimes where, you know, I don't get to catch all of it. Because it happens so fast.
Thank yeah, it you, does.
Lady. Let's see. Is that what is? Is it the ban for in Iowa?
Mm.
Ban on e-cigarettes for minors. Okay, I'm all for the no minors.
The so my
number's not working. What? Do I have the right number up? 6373726. Let me go ahead and refresh this.
Yeah, things are a little slow. You know, I could take a minute and go feed the hamsters.
You gonna go feed the hamster?
Yeah, you know, our internet's, you know, we're in a really small community.
Let me see if I can refresh this. All right, try the number again. That's the right number. And we're hooked up to Skype. So it should be working.
Did you reload your account?
Yeah.
From last week? Okay.
I just refreshed the page. But I don't know.
Yes.
That worked last week.
Yeah, I had to spend about 3 hours on Saturday morning watching your first three episodes.
There's a new Facebook group now where you can go to watch all your favorite episodes of shows. Oh, look, we got callers now. It's working. I guess I had to refresh the page. So let's take this caller. Caller and the 605 area code. Oh, it just dropped. What happened?
They probably hung up on hold too long.
Both of them dropped.
Oh.
They said, psych, we're going to call you, not. Weird. Okay, try it again. Call in again. I just had two show up. Oh, I hung up. Yeah, I'm all for the states putting the age limit for minors. I didn't realize that there were kiosks that were still trying to slide around that and sell stuff to 11-year-olds. That's ridiculous. Oh, well, thank you, Jim, for testing that. So that was Jim on the line. Dakota just crank called me. All right, so let's do a giveaway. Let's go ahead and start some of the juice giveaways. I'll go ahead and pull up the hat.
Oh.
I like the hat. Let me see if I can get my chatters list to work.
Just looking at my selection pads.
All right, so I have two Vaughn bots in the room. Let's see.
Wow.
Copy this. Copy all the viewers so we can start some of the giveaways. And I, mind you, I do have chicken waiting for me. I can't wait.
Yeah, do you have Prince Albert in the can, Dakota Jim?
What? All right, here we go. We're going to remove this one. I'm going to remove this one. I'm going to remove the word mods.
Yeah, chicken doesn't sound good. Savory in general doesn't sound good to me.
Yeah, I would never vape a chicken vape, but, you know, a bucket of chicken and some coleslaw, yeah, that's really sound. I haven't had dinner yet, so it was a late delivery.
Mm.
So I missed it. Let's see if I can get everything in here. All right, where's Manicam?
I don't know.
All right, so full screen. This is for the first juice. These were all 12 milligram, correct?
These are all 12 milligrams. First one is Jamaican 10 speed.
I need to box this better. Can you guys all see the hat? The magic hat?
Look at all them. I'll piff it if I win.
Here we go. Now we got the hat in there. Now I can move this away. I'm trying to work with all these boxes back here. All right, here we go. The winner is... Kudaman 68. Kudaman 68, you are the winner of Jamaican 10 Speed or Perfect Watermelon.
I'll give both of them away. Are you giving them a choice?
You want it to go to one person? It's up to you because you're paying for the shipping.
If you want to do two. Give him one, and Kudaman, just type what you want. You want watermelon or the 10 speed?
Kudaman, did Kudaman answer in chat already?
He wants a 10 speed. Perfect.
Okay. All right. So,
watermelon speed. Somewhere else. I'll write that down. Kudaman, 10 speed.
All right, so we're going to do the second juice. And thank you, Pammy, for that. You guys listen to what Country Pammy is putting in the room. And then I'll give it to, I'll send the info to Bob, too.
Okay.
XBS X-Dread. If I can see you put something in the room that you see that you are the winner. Please respond. Has anyone seen X Dread show up in the room yet? If not, we're going to re-roll.
Yep.
Yay.
You won. That'll be the watermelon or the perfect melon.
Perfect. Yay. Why does that keep popping up? Because I'm using the chat now. Okay. So that was our two juice giveaways. We have about a half hour to go, and we're still going to do a $25 gift certificate from One Stop. And we have a juice giveaway from Canyon Vapor.
You're welcome. Yeah, thank you to the sponsors. That's the word I'm looking for.
And if you guys weren't here earlier, we have a new host on Nova. Scope, who was actually on the show last week, is now hosting. He's on the show right before me doing some DIY with his stuff or DIY with rebuildables.
He
had a great show earlier, too.
Yes, Dredd, you won the watermelon.
Do I have enough wings to share? No, you don't get my wings. I like wings and I like chicken legs. I like the dark meat. Is the 10 off for still good? I'm not sure. That's I didn't ask him. I hadn't spoke to him today. Jonathan, if you're in the room, could you answer that? I don't remember what it was. Was it 10% off code during the show? The show's almost over now. We are not raffling my chicken. That's my food.
Reminds me of that commercial where they're auctioning off the girls' groceries.
And my creamy coleslaw. See, I'm getting hungry just sitting here. I'm going to go get my food and eat in front of you guys. I'm just kidding.
Yeah, you can put me on full cam. I don't mind.
Oh, yeah. Dr. Oxide is a new host here as well, who will be doing his first show on Friday at 6 p.m. Eastern time. Come check out Dr. Oxide's first show.
So, do you see my little dripper?
Oh, look at your purple. Oh, purple. Yeah. Is that a octopus?
Yes.
Nice.
I won that from Ross Sanders, Junkie Rock 13.
Nice. I always miss his shows, too. I'm so busy at that time of the day. I'm so sad that I miss his shows. Junkie has a great show on Saturdays before Mod Envy. And he is the second highest show with viewers since last Saturday now.
Yeah, he was amazed. He was really, I was watching his show before Mod Envy, and he was really amazed. He was psyched.
And we just had the 1 year for Mod Envy, because Mod Envy started when we were still Elixir. Well, February 1st, if you haven't heard it already, is Nova Broadcasting's 1 year anniversary. Yay!
Seems to me I read a post on that somewhere.
Yes. When is my 1 year? I don't get a 1 year because I've been doing this too long.
Yeah. She's coming up on 3 or 4.
My 3 year vapiversary will be February 7th, though. Let's all go to the lobby.
Yeah. And get ourselves a drink.
Last Saturday was a 7 and somebody said 22-minute show. 7-hour and 22-minute show.
Yeah, I made it longer than Mandy did, but I still cut out about 4 in the morning.
I think they punched me because I started singing, "Let's all go to the lobby." Two years maple tweak. Nice. Yeah.
Congrats.
Yeah, I've been, the snoring, I'm going to say that was Smokey snoring. That was not my husband.
You know, the funny thing is at first when it happened, I thought Tiger had somebody off camera.
I tried to mute it as much as I could. It was time for me to go anyway.
Very good, Elf.
In an hour. Hey, Babe Hi Guy. You had nightmares about walking popcorn after that video? Nice, John. 1 year for you.
Yeah.
You're gonna blame it on Smokey. Loki. Are you reading that?
I am. Okay. The deal with light affecting your juice is that nicotine, oxidizes? Is that the right term? Yeah. In indirect sunlight, it oxidizes, changes colors, basically. It'll make your juice darker. I don't know that I've read anything that it affects the nicotine strength or flavor, but it looks darker.
What do you want to pimp, Vape High Guy? You said, can I pimp my new project? Tiger doesn't snore. I've never seen Tiger snore. Joe does a good impression of snoring.
Yeah.
Yeah, if there was an issue with it, a big issue with the sunlight, we'd all be in trouble when we were outside.
SoCal, Tortuga. The heat can affect flavorings.
Well, if you're out on the beach, you won't get any vapor in the hot sun. Just saying.
Well, yeah, and I've heard of people, and read about people who left their juice in a hot car, and it's gone terribly wrong. It sours.
It cooks it, too. It's like cooking it. Before you vape it. So it can taste funky. I don't put my stuff in a dark closet to steep. Everyone's different. Everyone has their own special ways to do it. You just have to find what works best for you. If you find putting it in a dark closet or a drawer works best for you, do it. I know some people take the lids off their juice to let them steep. I don't do that. I don't want things crawling in them. You never know. They say
some
we eat spiders
like,
when we sleep.
Some people don't like colorings, but I like coloring. When I mix my juices, I like colors in them, so I can tell which one they are. Which one they are, just...
Those vape bands are going to be great for telling what juices you have on your tanks. I thought that was an awesome idea that Vapor Owl has started with vape bands.
Yeah. Yeah, that's...
Did chat stop? Anyone notice that?
I think...
No? Okay.
It's rolling. On my end. For me. Personally. My experience.
Yeah, some people are picky about coloring. Some people are like, whatever. It's just coloring. So, it's preference.
Yeah. Here. I'm using food coloring. I'm going to say generally accepted as safe for vapor.
All right, let's do another giveaway, too, while we're here. We're at 8:33. Let's go ahead and do Canyon Vapors giveaway. I'm going to clear the clipboard. Oh, I think I am. Clear list. And redraw. Oh, what's going on with my chatters list? It's like not showing up all the way.
Well, Fire King, the thing you need to know when you're first starting out DIY is to make small batches. If you bought juice from anywhere in a small, 5 or 10 milliliter bottle, save it. Rinse it out. It's a very cheap way to make a very small test batch. And don't add your nicotine.
I am actually down to 6 milligrams nicotine now.
Yeah.
Yay me. And so far I haven't killed anyone.
Fire King, you could use a 10 milliliter bottle too, but just when I get a new flavor, I will mix up about 3 milliliters of flavor and juice. Well, when I'm testing, when I'm mixing up a small test batch, I don't need to add nicotine because it doesn't really affect the flavor to me. But if I don't like the flavoring, I can just pour it down the sink and it only cost me like 4 cents to mix it. Where I feel bad if I put the nicotine, which is, you know, considerably more expensive, in there.
Right. And Albie's right. The first video I did, I went over the very basics of starting out with DIY, and you can find those on YouTube. Look up Vaping Mandycat. You can find me. All right, so we're going to do a Canyon Vapor giveaway right now. Pull the hat back up. Yeah, here's the hat. Canyon Vapor, if you pick out a juice, I suggest trying Ghost Berries. It's the one I like. They have Flavors by Joe. If you like Flavors by Joe, and it's from Joe, the original Joe, not imitation Joe. So some great flavors on his website. You guys go and like his page on Facebook and check out his website. Thanks, Pammy, for posting that. Scope 666. You just won some juice. Now I just need to see your name. Yes, not the clone Joe. It's the real Joe.
There he is. Scope's in there.
Pammy just put my info and how to contact me, and Scope knows how to contact me anyway.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Yay. Yeah.
And then right before we end the show, we'll talk about some One Stop DIY and give away a $25 gift certificate to One Stop. So we'll clear this. Now, Bob, can I put you on the main screen for a minute while I run to the potty? Sure.
Well,
the room is yours.
Wow. Hello there, my name is Bob Lauer, and I'm a host.
I'll be right back.
I don't know if you all saw at the beginning of the show, I have a ton of stuff, and, you know, we are, some people get into DIY and into vaping, and they're going to save money, and versus smoking tobacco, I have calculated that I will start saving money next June. Yeah, next June, I believe. If I just stay the course and don't buy anything else. Yeah. Because it's a hobby, man. I have got, you know, I've got like 8 Vivinova tanks that I don't use. I've got 4 Pro tanks. I bought the new airflow control on the bottom of the Pro tank, you know, for the Aspire, and put that on my old Pro tank version 1. Bought 3 of those, you know. And I've got a ton of mods, you know, some big old things that I don't even use anymore. And I've got a bunch of flavorings and supplies and but it's healthier. It's better for me. And no, I don't have a reel. The blue one is a T-Max. Sigelli T-Max. I'm not sure what a reel was. I've never had one, I've got four AGAT2s. You know, my, and until the till the Kraken came along, I would say I use my AGAT2s mostly. But I really like the Kraken because my AGAT2s are so old that they don't have the ability for a double wick. The new ones have a second hole, a second wick hole. Mine don't.
I know some people are, do you find you spend less for vaping than what you did for cigarettes still with all the stuff that you buy?
I probably do. Well, you were out.
Because I spent $600 between me and my husband, $600 a month on cigarettes between us both. Yeah. We now spend our maintenance and what we use. I mean, I don't go out and buy every new thing anymore. I'm pretty satisfied with what I have. I used to be on a collector's kick, but I don't anymore. So maybe $150 to $200 a month on vape gear. Unless I buy a Ferrari.
Yeah. I'm really down, you know, until I bought this Zen Altus, you know, the big 1860 mechanical, you know, which that set me back a little bit. I was doing pretty good up until then. But then, you know, since then, I got my, I bought another mechanical, what do they call it? The Poldiac clone.
Mm-hmm. And someone had a point. Cigs go up in smoke, but you can always resell your mods, which is true. A lot of people, you know, if they want something new, they discount the mods they already have. Or they're like me and they just give them away and go buy a new one.
Okay, what do I taste my flavors on? Well, I've got this other really cheap dripper. You know, my HH357.
Nice. 510 atomizer there.
Yeah. Well, yeah, that's my Cisco HH357. Mm-hmm. Which I suppose I can throw it on here.
No, Lake Nettie's mod broke last night.
Oh, I heard. I've never really broken a mod. I guess I'm lucky that way.
I know CB is a huge fan of the HH357 atomizers.
Yeah.
What's your favorite rebuildable?
Mine? Mm-hmm. Well, as I was saying, the AGA T2 was my favorite, and I'm I think I'm going to go with the Kraken right now because I love that. I love the protection of the glass and I love the engraving. I like the dual holes and the adjustable airflow.
Now, did you set yours up with dual coil?
No.
No, you didn't.
No, because I'm already running this at 0.67 ohms. I don't... Mm-hmm. I can't imagine going lower than that.
Now, when I first started out buying vape gear, it seemed like I was spending a lot.
Pardon me. I'm using a stainless steel mesh wick. Now, maybe if I was using it more as a dripper, you know, maybe I'd do that.
So you like the mesh better on it?
Yeah, I do. I've got some coils and mesh that I've been running for 6 months.
What's your thought on cotton, using cotton? I've seen some controversy about cotton lately. I was thinking about going to cotton because everyone said the flavor is better. But then I've heard some things that make sense as far as bacteria growth and this and that. And I kind of went, ew, I don't want a fungus on my mod. What do you think?
I actually have a little bag of boiled cotton balls right here.
Well, someone's pointed out that fungus can start growing on the cotton if it's just sitting. But I don't know. You know, it was kind of gross to think about it, but there's never been any real studies. And then Demetrius had a reaction to the whole cotton thing.
I will say that for months, I used cotton yarn to rebuild my Vivinova tanks without any problem.
Well, and then I saw somebody said, well, they change their cotton every night, which, okay, that's great. Someone like me, I do a rebuildable, and maybe it's not good either. I don't know. I let it sit for a week or two, and, you know, I might vape on it once or twice a day, if that. But I never thought about that.
Thanks, Morlord. Mm-hmm. He says he does mold remediation and wouldn't worry.
And I see Rich might be having a reaction to cotton. So there's some new things coming out with the cotton trend. It took a few months, but it seems like there might be some ups and some downs about it. There are funguses among us every day. You are right.
Yes, yes, L.M. Fisher. That was avid vapor for the HH357. I bought mine at Vape Bash, so he built it right in front of me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Well, Cisco's assistant, he didn't.
Sorry, sister. You want me to sing it again? Let's all go to the lobby and have ourselves a treat.
Oh.
Oh. Pammy muted me. Oh, come on.
She's looking for the mute button.
So I don't know. I was about to jump on the cotton bandwagon, and then I started hearing some negatives come out. And, you know, I haven't had any issues with my silica. So I'm thinking maybe I should just stick to what my body likes and what works for me.
Well, and that's one thing you have to consider is what really works for you. I rebuild my EVOD heads with cotton.
Oh, okay.
So that works for me, but then I rebuild those about once a week.
And you've never had a problem with your cotton as far as your health. Nothing's changed. Somebody said they felt like they had more mucus, like they were starting to cough mucus. That was the other thing I read.
Well, as I said, I've got, you know, 50 plus years of abuse to this body. And
and not that sensitive about much. CB's body's sensitive to a lot of VG. It gives her mucus, and she starts coughing up. So I guess it falls down to what your body can handle. I just don't think I'm going to travel down the road of cotton right now because I'm seeing more and more stuff pop up every day about it. Yeah. And my lungs are very sensitive. I can't vape over 4.5. I can't do dual coil too long without hacking up a lung. So I know my body is very sensitive to heat, for one.
Yeah.
And CB finds it fine for her rebuilding. But you don't vape on your rebuildables all day, do you, CB, with cotton? Or do you just try them to try a juice or something? I mean, the people that are vaping on cotton all day, I mean, they drip on it, they tank it in a K-Fun. Cool. Well, I see you guys just have to find what works for your body. And if you find that you're coughing up more stuff suddenly or you're breaking out, just stop doing it then.
Yeah, I don't have a K-Fun, but I did get, and I think it's similar, a Rocket clone replica. Not sure if that's exactly a K-Fun replica or something, and really have not crazy about it.
Oh, you have. You didn't like it.
It keeps flooding. It keeps flooding, and I just don't. It's too much trouble.
I didn't look at the link, Vapai Guy. If I open too many boxes, I could crash the show. So yeah. I try to stick with what I've already got open on my browsers. My computer's memory is really low, so the more stuff I run and open, the more I crash. New vapor, you have clear mucus coming out. From vaping, or is that just you got a cold?
Thanks, sister.
Where's it coming out at? You know that I want to try the ready wick because CB is absolutely right about the silica. When you see all those little shards of silica that come out when you're playing with it, I really want to try the ready wick because it looks better for me without as much fraying. As opposed to brown mucus. How long have you been vaping now, Noob? Because I coughed for the first month of vaping. And then, of course, every now and then I get a little coffee afterwards, but I'm pretty good now. Only time I get mucus is when I'm sick or getting cold. I cried the first day I woke up and I wasn't coughing anymore because I was horrible. When I'd wake up in the morning and take that first big breath of air, I would literally cough myself into wanting to puke because I was coughing so much. I'd start gagging on my cough and mucus, which was nasty. And phlegm balls shooting out everywhere. And you guys probably haven't heard my phlegm ball story. I'll tell it another time.
Thank you.
It was horrible. So I cried the day I woke up and I didn't cough like that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, come on. We've all had phlegm ball shootout. Come on. If you were a smoker, you've had to have a phlegm ball shootout. It'd be like, oh, wipe off the, you know, dashboard on your steering wheel.
Yeah, I'm not much of a dripper, though. You know, maybe that's why I haven't gotten into cotton builds that much.
We got a little bit less than 10 minutes. We better do this giveaway for one stop. I got to chat with everybody and completely lost track of time.
Oh, my.
So let's do this.
It's okay, yeah.
Oh, there we go. I'll save my phlegm ball story with the. I had a doctor have an incident with me. I'll save that for another show.
Give me something to look forward to.
There you go. You can look forward to Mandy's phlegm ball story.
Ooh. BB&A.
Let me pull up the Manny cam. All right, this is for one stop guy. Guys, this is the big giveaway of the night. I'm going to put her banner up. Get the hat here. Here we go. This is for $25 gift certificate to One Stop DIY. If you guys are new to DIY, you can find every flavor at One Stop. You can buy the little bottles if you want to sample it, and I suggest getting little bottles to start if you're unsure of a flavor. So here we go.
That's right, Vape High Guy. Smoking made you hack.
Rhonda, H-O-1, you are the winner. Go ahead and put a 1 in the room to let me know you see this. Congratulations.
Makes you stop.
Yay. Pammy just put my info down there. You're going to email me. You're going to make an account at One Stop DIY so you can go shopping. And once I tell her you were the winner, she will put a credit of $25 in your cart. Yay! And I haven't done this the whole show, so I'm going to do this. This is for all my winners tonight.
Did I miss her? Or did she actually post?
Too bad Tony's not here to go, I hate that cat. I hate that cat.
I like the cat.
Alright, so hopefully everybody got my info there. Let's see, let's turn this off. We'll just turn off the calls. No callers tonight, which is fine. You guys don't want to talk to me. I just don't talk. That's okay. I definitely want to say check out One Stop DIY's own line of flavors as well. I enjoyed her flavors. I'm going to mix some more of that later. We got 5 minutes to go. I want to thank Bob for coming on the show tonight. Thank you for arranging your schedule to be on tonight and showing us your DIY techniques.
Well, it was a pleasure being here. Hopefully I didn't bore too many people to sleep.
And I want to thank all my sponsors, Canyon Vapor, One Stop DIY, and Heartland Vapes for sponsoring the show. And like I said, next week, something a little different, not DIY related, but I'm probably going to give my VTR away. So I might want to come for that. Cause I don't use it. And stay tuned, guys. Celtic is coming on next for you guys. I think Loki's on the show too tonight, right? Loki, you're in the room. I see you bouncing around. And I'm going to go eat some chicken.
Sounds like a good plan.
Yes, do not use oils to make your juices. Please, PG-based, alcohol-based. Do not use oil. Yes, Rhonda, you won a $25 gift certificate to One Stop DIY. So did I put my email up for you? I know Cammy posted it in the room. Let me throw it on the screen. There it is, mandycat3333@aol.com. You need to email me. You won $25 from our lovely sponsor, One Stop DIY. Aw, I miss you, Jamie. I bet you're having better weather than us.
Yeah.
Well, we're supposed to have a heat wave Saturday, right? Was it 21? What'd you say? 21 degrees? 24
yeah,
degrees?
Something like that.
Yay, heat wave.
90 seconds.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm registering -5 right now.
All right, I think Celtic and Loki are, let me just check real quick while I got that up there.
Okay.
Let me look at my Skype, see if they're ready for their show. Let's see. Yep, they're ready. Okay, good, great. All right, guys, I'm going to throw this last thing up. And thank you so much for coming in.
60 seconds.
I'll see you guys again next Tuesday.